It's described as nothing short of breathtaking, a points drop never before seen on the US markets. This closing bell might as well have been an alarm, so savage was the selling. In percentage terms, it had less impact than the crash of 87, but it still left traders and investors shell-shocked.
You saw it, didn't you? It was down some.
Why? How come?
I don't know.
Bad day.
Bad day for you?
Another one, yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Too many in a row.
The plunge was sparked by a jump in US inflation. The fear, a bigger hike in interest rates, the only remedy. It was enough to force the Dow Jones down 616 points, a drop of 5.5%. The fragile technology stocks even harder hit, the Nasdaq index in freefall down nearly 10%. It lost a quarter of its value in just 1 week.
Once this body started in motion, it was very, very difficult to put the brakes on. And by 1 o'clock, everyone threw in the towel and said it's a foregone conclusion. These things are going down. We'll wait till Monday to get back in the game.
But that game could be a rough one when our markets open on Monday morning. The expectation is that Australian stocks will be hit too.
The few days that we have in the market next week will certainly be volatile.
The only saviour, Aussie stocks are not as overvalued as those in the US, and some have lost up to half their value already.
There will be some very good buying out there. I think people who panic will be probably be making those bargains available to the canny investor.
And spare a thought for Bill Gates. The Wall Street collapse cost the world's richest man a mere $1.8 billion this week alone. Eddie Meyer, 10 News.